Hello, my name is Shweta Singh. Welcome to my life page. I'm going to talk about genetics and conservation, but before that, let me introduce myself. So, I did my BSc in Zoology from the Dayalbagh Educational Institute, Agra, and then I did my master's in Zoology and from the same institute, and did my master dissertation in molecular biology. I joined Wildlife Institute of India in 2013 in All India Tiger Monitoring Project, in which I worked as a research biologist in genetics component. And then I joined another project in same lab in genetic component, that is genetic connectivity of large carnivore in landscape, and I'm presently working as a senior research fellow in same project. Our work starts from like forest department, and our researchers collect all the samples and other information. So they send us all these samples. So we deal with tissue sample, with scat samples, that is the poop or the waste sample that we have. So in this component, we basically extracted DNA from all these samples that we have, and then through the PCR we multiply or we increase the amount of DNA, and then we also identify the species, whether this scat is belong to the tiger or the leopard or any other species. After getting this much information, then we go to the higher level. We done so many analysis, so through that we know what is the status of the species in a genetic aspect. Like, we have so many numbers, like in a particular area we have so many numbers of animals, but what if the heterozygosity or the genetics or what we can the gene pool or the genes, their like variety or the diversity is very low. So what we can do if there is any disease, it happens in any population, then it can wipe out the whole population. So it is very necessary to work on this aspect also. So after getting the formal education, you can work in any lab, like as an intern, or you can work as a researcher. So where you can learn a basic technique, like how to do work in a lab, like basic steps, like what are the different machines we use, different composition, different components that we used in our lab. Like, we have different steps. First, we learn about the DNA extraction or the samples or different things. And then you can do like other things also, or advanced things. It required so much concentration and focused work. Because this is the work which do not require any physical thing. It required only your focus. If you can focus on one thing, then you can work on this field very well. Otherwise, it's like a kaam chala work that, okay, fine, humne kar liya. We travel so many places, and we travel in our areas where for tourists, for laymen, it's not open. But for researcher like us, for scientists, it's open. So in these areas, we observe so many species. We can see them, we can observe them, their behavior, how they are roaming here and there. The major challenge which we faced is the fundraising problem, because we do not have so much fund for doing work for all the species. If we have some charismatic species, like we have a tiger or a leopard or any endangered species, if we worked on them, so yeah, not so easily, but we can get funds for that. But if any bird or anything, like a small insect, like any spider, if it is endangered, we hardly get any fund for that. As I already mentioned, we got so many samples or so many data from forest department. So first of all, we catalog, or we make a list of all those samples which we got, and after that we do the DNA extraction. So depend on the samples, we follow the protocols. So it took like around a whole day for doing two sample or three samples, because it's a very long process. So in between, when we have an incubation time in between this protocol, so we do the PCR. So I mentioned in PCR, we do, like, we have a small amount of DNA, so we increase the amount of DNA using the PCR technique. And then after doing the PCR and the isolation work, we do our general, like, gel electrophoresis. So for the species identification, so like for, if like starting from getting a sample and till the species identification, it took around 2 to 3 days for a sample, and we have more than 2000 to 3000 samples. So we need to do so much work, like we need to work day and night for completing like our all the samples. So this is what I do in a day. So I hope I gave you a balanced overview about my profession. Thank you so much.